There will always be ups and downs in our life, and that is what makes it so interesting. These lows can sometimes be so unbearable that getting out of it may seem quite impossible. At that time, your personal strength determines how soon you can get out of it. With conscious effort, you can get out of it faster. Conscious, continuous, and methodical effort, that is. This process is called self-renewal, and today I'd like to explore what self-renewal is and give you 4 steps to redeem yourself. You all know what self-development is, right? Self-renewal is part of this self-development process where you're doing things or activities or getting involved in things that make you feel good about yourself. This could be something as simple as reading a book or listening to your favorite music, a simple stroll in the park, or catching up with your friends for a coffee. Self-renewal activities can also help you get out of your comfort zone and explore new possibilities. So in case if you're stuck down in dumps and you're feeling very low because of a hurt or a pain caused by somebody, which is your comfort zone. The comfort in that is where you're feeling like a victim and there's a lot of self-pity coming in for yourself, which is extremely comfortable to be in, to coming out to new possibilities, which is moving on or letting it go. Self-renewal is all about preparing to take that risk and developing the courage to act despite your fear. The key word here is developing, because you're not really born with it, but you must be interested and prepared to make that change in your life. Once you're mentally ready, these are the steps you can follow. Step number one, affirm yourself. I've spoken about this previously. Affirmations is a powerful tool for transformation if you use it regularly. So the next time when you're low and down in dumps, use positive sentences such as "this too shall pass," or "this incident is making me stronger," or "this incident is making me wiser." And if you are upset or angry with somebody, then affirmations such as "they don't know what they're talking about," "I am enough," will help you move on. The sound of your own voice will guide you to a peaceful, positive place. The best way to use this tool is when you cultivate a habit of affirming yourself regularly. So what you can really do is to create a list of affirmations and keep it ready with you. And these need to be something that create positivity or sort of motivate you. And whenever you are low and down in dumps, just read them aloud continuously. Step number two, change positions physically and mentally. So when you're down in dumps and you're sitting in a particular position which is making you feel very, that is the time you're feeling very low, you can deliberately get out from that position and probably either look the other way or change the direction of your sitting, or you can also walk out into the fresh air. That is physical changing of position. Mentally, when you feel like a victim and getting into the self-pity mode, you can change your position and say something like, "I am not a victim, the other person is a victim," and start sympathizing with them, and you will feel good about it. Changing positions will help you get out of the wallowing and make you feel better. Step number three is to distract yourself. Do some activity where your mind is diverted or mind is taken off from whatever that is making you feel low. It's not running away from it, it's taking a pause from it. You can do many things during this pause. You can say your prayers, you can maybe paint if you love painting, you can cook your favorite dish if you love cooking. Anything that can get your mind away from it. For me, speaking with my friends or even cleaning out my desk is actually therapeutic, and that's how I distract myself. Previously, I have tried meditation and it didn't really work for me, because when you are low and down in dumps, you're shrouded with so many negative thoughts. And if you're left alone and if your mind is constantly thinking of those negative thoughts, you can get into a loop. The best thing that I've realized I can do is to get out and completely occupy your mind in doing an activity so that, you know, I'm like away from negative thoughts. Step number four, find a solution. There is a solution for every problem. If you cannot see it right now, it's just because you haven't explored it enough. All you need to do is put your heart and mind into it, and the solution will come to you. Refocus and setting a new direction in your life is critical to self-renewal. New commitments to new priorities will help you keep your hope alive. In the words of Martin Luther King Jr., we must accept finite disappointments, but never lose infinite hope. There you go. These are the 4 steps that help me get my mojo back whenever I'm down in dumps. This is my secret formula for maintaining my motivation and positivity. What do you do when you are down in dumps? Do you have a secret formula that you can share with me? I'd love to hear from you. Looking forward to a meaningful conversation. Take care until then and have a wonderful time. Bye. And of course, if you like this video, please hit a like button, share it with your friends, and do subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it already. Thank you for watching.